So till now we have seen two questions. Now we'll look at some more questions and we'll study about other concepts using questions directly. So that's very helpful when we look at questions. So let's see another case where we have continuous excitation. So the continuous excitation can have three different forms. The first form can be random, another can be sinusoidal, or third can be impulse. So let's say the continuous excitation is seen in seismic waves in earthquake, where that seismograph records the waveform or some other excitations which the earth is experiencing. So we can generalize it, but the constant is magnitude. So magnitude remains the constant. And as of now, we are taking an undamped system. So this is how the function is, the response to general excitation, unit excitation, and F of tau is going to be a constant F zero, because that's constant and we are using convolution integral concept right now. So we have got the response X of T in terms of F zero M omega N and Xn. So the maximum value of X T will be when cos omega nt is going to be minus 1, and we'll have the value of 2f0 by m omega n, and the minimum value will be 1 minus 1 when cos omega nt is equal to 0. So we have the value 0. Now, so this is how the response looks like. And now let's see step excitation with damping. So what does that mean? It means that we are giving that excitation with damping, and there is some time delay also. So we have incorporated time delay, we have incorporated the damping also. And the effect of damping is whenever we had omega, we are changing omega n by omega d. So there were two omegas over there. And time delay means wherever we had t, we are replacing t by t minus tau. And when we have to introduce damping, we have to introduce this exponential decay factor. And in that, you must remember that we are using omega n instead of omega d. So just that we are giving step excitation. So that's the value of constant excitation, as we have seen earlier, with a time delay and damping. So this is the general integration we have right now. And the f of tau was f0, which was constant. So we need to integrate it and get the answer. So we are using different concepts of integration and we are getting the answer. So this is the final expression which we have. And this is very complex expression. So we can convert it to simpler terms where we have sine and cos terms only. And how do we do that? So let's say we are taking theta omega n is equal to a1 and omega d is equal to a2. And they are perpendicular. Let's say they are perpendicular. So we have a1 and a2. So a will be a1 square plus a2 square, the square root. And when we do this addition, we'll get a is equal to omega n. And we can define one more factor phi. So we have converted a1, a2. There were two things. Omega d also has omega n and theta. So we have two variables. We have converted two variables to a1, a2, two variables. And then we are again converting to another two variables, a and phi. So we can get phi, which is defined in terms of tan inverse theta upon square root of 1 minus theta square. So we can now directly substitute that things over here and get the value of the final response. And this is how the final response looks like for step excitation with damping. And this is how the response will look like. So this was the thing without damping, and we have seen that it was having a magnitude, maximum magnitude as 2f0 by k, and minimum was 0. The same will be followed in damping factor, but the mean value is f0 by k, and it dampens out with the mean value f0 by k at the later time. So this is with damping, this is without damping. And we have seen this earlier also, the particular solution and transient solution. So particular solution means a steady state solution, or particular solution, transient solution means it is coming from homogeneous part. And If you want to combine them, we can combine them directly and get the combined response. So this is the combined response. So there are two approaches we have used. We have used one of the approach where we have splitted the excitation. So we have combined the terms for the general excitation with respect to unit impulse, and the transient response was without any impulse, just the transient decay part, exponential decay part. And then we had applied particular solution where we were applying force or the impulse. We have combined these two solutions and got the combined response. And the other way was directly using the convolution integral, which I have explained earlier. And the beauty is both the answers or both the responses are same by convolution integral and direct solution. So we can use any of the concept, but since the integration is very easy for us, for simpler functions, we can better use that term, that type of concept to use that to solve the answers. We'll stop over here.